Former Home and Away star Isabel Lucas is getting behind a News Limited campaign to stop Japanese whaling, signing an online petition calling for an end to the slaughter of humpbacks. This is not the first campaign Isabel has been involved in. She recently travelled to Japan to stop the slaughter of dolphins. Now, a warning, some of these pictures are upsetting.
When I was in the water and the fishermen came over, they yelled at us a few times, went away, and then they came back again. They got really, really angry and confrontational, and they pulled out these long sticks with prods on the end and started attacking us with them.
Got
it. Oh, f***ing hard to walk away. F***ing hard to walk away.
What is the problem?
Jamaya! Misawaria!
Just innocence being slaughtered.
Innocence
being taken away. Because dolphins and whales are probably one of the friendliest animals on the face of this planet.
And Isabel Lucas joins us now from our Melbourne studios. Good morning to you, Isabel. Thanks for your time.
Thank you for having me.
Isabel, can you tell us what it was that led you to get behind the anti-whaling cause?
Yeah, I think anyone who sees the footage and can actually witness what they're doing, the process in which they're undertaking to kill these dolphins and whales, cannot help but be motivated to do something. It's really shocking. There's no words to describe how cruel it is. I think that's basically how I got on board.
Your involvement with that dolphin campaign has actually landed you in a bit of hot water in Japan.
Yeah, that's correct. We have been issued with arrest warrants. So if we do go back to Japan, we do risk being arrested. We were aware of that already being a possibility when we were in Japan. We did have our wetsuits wrapped in plastic slips in our passports wrapped in plastic slips in our wetsuits in case we were detained then and there. But at the moment, we're assessing the situation of the different possibilities of what might happen if we go back in February next year. And, yeah, seeing whether it will be beneficial going back or not.
But your belief is you would be arrested?
It's probable, it is likely, but also if we up the ante and have a lot more support and people coming with us, then it is also unlikely that they will want to be drawing so much more attention to the issue by arresting us and other people, so it could be a positive thing.
Now, the Japanese whaling vessels have already started heading south. Can you just remind us exactly what they're hunting?
That's correct. The Japanese whaling fleets have just come to the Australian waters, to the Southern Ocean Whale Sanctuary, and they are Australian territorial waters, and they want to kill over 1,000 different whales, humpback whales, which are endangered, fin whales, which are also endangered, and 940 minke whales. And it's really to be thinking about actually hunting endangered mammals and whales. It's quite absurd, and it's really our responsibility as Australians to take action with this and really ask the government to put this on as a government agenda issue, and to ask them to take action and reinforce the whale moratorium.
Isabel, how aware do you think the Japanese people are about these activities?
The response in Japan, the polls are showing that around 70% of the Japanese oppose whaling. So it's not related. I mean, the Japanese are beautiful people. We really love the country and the culture. It just really illustrates purely how it is a political issue. It's an economical issue.
Well, you're the first one to sign the Daily Telegraph's petition. What sort of effect do you think it's going to have?
Well, we really hope that it will raise the bar and create a lot more support so that it can become a government agenda issue, and that there will be a dramatic change, because it really is. It's our responsibility as Australians to make the Japanese whaling official... Japanese officials responsible for the whaling, for, you know, we really want them to understand and respect that there are Australians and people all around the world that really want these whales protected for future generations.
Well, Isabel, we can only hope it's going to have an effect. I know you're very busy at the moment. You're in the middle of filming a Steven Spielberg miniseries, so we thank you so much for your time this morning.
Thank you.
Thanks. And if you'd like to join Isabel's fight to save the whales, you can sign up to Sydney's Daily Telegraph petition. You can log on to our website, 9msn.com.au/today, and follow the links.
Good.